The effectiveness of sulfanilamide derives from the fact that all cells need folic acid in order to make DNA and RNA, and bacteria must synthesize folic acid. We get folic acid from the foods in our diet. Without folic acid, the bacteria that cause infections cannot grow and spread throughout your body. The bacteria need folic acid to synthesize the nitrogen bases that are the components of DNA. Three molecules are bonded together to make folic acid: a purine molecule, para-aminobenzoic acid, or PABA, and glutamate. In the reaction, each part of the synthesis splits out water molecules. The reaction that produces folic acid. Sulfanilamide has a shape and a charge distribution that is very similar to that of PABA. When sulfanilamide is present, it can take the place of PABA in the synthesis of folic acid. An enzyme is required in cells to synthesize folic acid. The enzyme is responsible for splitting water out to form chemical bonds. When sulfanilamide replaces PABA, the last bond cannot occur. There is no OH group present to split water out from. Therefore, folic acid does not form. Sulfanilamide is substituted for PABA. In the laboratory today, we will both synthesize sulfanilamide. We will test the ability of the sulfanilamide to stop the growth of bacteria on a petri dish. We will use the bacteria Bacillus cereus. The first step in the procedure is to weigh 5 grams of acetanilid into a 125 milliliter Erlenmeyer flask. The acetanilid flakes have a high surface area, so what we're going to do is melt them to reduce the surface area
over low Bunsen burner heat. Now, we will allow the liquid time to cool. In the next part of this lab, we will add a very dangerous liquid, chlorosulfonic acid, to the acid annulid. Chlorosulfonic acid is not a nice chemical. And to show you, we need to add just a little bit to water so you can see how violently it reacts. So now that the acid annulid has solidified, we will take the flask to the fume hood and add 13 milliliters of the deadly reagent. The next step is to take the reaction mixture back to our lab station and position the flask over a station hood, turn the water on to pull the nasty, wicked fumes out before they dissolve our face and our lungs. The reaction is more efficient at high temperatures, so we're going to turn the heat up on high for 30 seconds and then reduce the heat to low while the reaction continues. Now that the reaction is complete, the next step is to take the reaction mixture to the fume hood and pour it on ice. So now what we're going to do is take the product back to our lab station and stir it while we prepare for vacuum filtration so that we can isolate the product. And there we have it, the intermediate. We are now ready to prepare sulfanilamide. So we will transfer our chemical product from the Buchner funnel to a 250 milliliter beaker. Now, in the fume hood, we will add 40 milliliters of 15 molar ammonium hydroxide, or ammonia solution, to the reaction mixture. Heating will speed the nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reaction should now be complete, so we will add some distilled water to our intermediate. Stir completely. And then we need to filter again. Then we need to rinse any excess ammonia from the reaction with more distilled water. Now we're going to transfer the chemical product to a 250 milliliter beaker. In the fume hood, now we will add hydrochloric acid to the reaction. The hydrochloric acid will break the acetyl group free from the intermediate and should produce acetic acid. All right, our sulfanilamide is finished now, so we can test it against some other antibiotics. So we are going to inoculate a petri dish with some Bacillus cereus. To test our sulfanilamide, we will compare its effectiveness to four other antibiotics. We are going to use tweezers to aseptically transfer the Sensi discs to the media plate. So we'll push each one of the Sensi discs down into the media. Now we're going to put a little bit of the sulfanilamide that we have prepared in the very middle of the media plate.
You know you did. You're right.